So, thank you very much for inviting us, and we deeply appreciate to give us a good opportunity to introduce our museum today. I'm Koichi Shibukawa, professor and manager of curatorial division of our museum. And probably you can see Dr. Yamada as a presenter of this section in this the Basin Heritage book, but unfortunately he's not here. And on behalf of him, I'm here now. I heard this from him about 1 week ago. So I don't know what happened in my life, but I got an opportunity to come to such a beautiful city, very far from my hometown and in front of you. Anyway, let's start to talk. Please wait. No. Back. Okay, this is the first and this is the second. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Last year, our museum, a small prefectural museum of nature, became winner of both excellent communication design and fair and exhibition of the German Design Award 2018. Our museum was opened in 2016 with a renovation of the closed high school buildings, and school furniture such as desks and chairs were used to the exhibition like this. Yeah. This unique design is highly evaluated worldwide, fortunately. Okay. And before my talking about the museum, director of our museum, Dr. Yasuda, has a speech to you. Please, Yasuda.
Instead of me, Professor and Dr. Koichi Shibukawa, his mail address was written in 90 pages in an abstract volume. This is 90 pages. This, please look. So then here, the Koichi Shibukawa, Koichi underbar Shibukawa at mat. prefecture.shizuoka.lg.jp, all capital letters are recognized. So then Professor Dr. Shibukawa is a manager of our museum, and he will more detail about our museum. I came here passing through the Lyon, France, and I understood that Europe, western tip of the Euro-Asian continent, forest was regenerated. This is very wonderful. And we received German Design Award for the excellent communication 2018. I think forest civilization will become the new concept of the civilization in the latter half of the 21st centuries. So then I will return to the again the other. Yanasai. Hi, okay. I'm sorry. That's it.
Sorry. Thank you, boss. And back to my part. Okay, next one. This one. Very difficult for me. So in this presentation, sorry, back to my partner. Okay. So in this presentation, I like to talk about photopics as shown here. First, I like to show several photographs before and after the renovation, in order to introduce the appearance of our museum. This is a photograph of the entrance area for school teachers before. And after the renovation, it's changed to the entrance of our museum by painting the walls with white and sky blue museum color. This is the entrance for the high school student. It was drastically modified into large and sophisticated exhibition room number 10. And typical small size classroom changed to the other exhibition room by making additional walls in front of the windows for blocking sunlight. The corridor changed to a part of the exhibition area after the renovation. And as you know, the museum needs a large backyard space. This is a photograph of the cooking room before. It's changed to the storage for fish specimens. Likewise, the computer room changed to the storage for insect specimens. We renovate all of the rooms with no exceptions. You know what is this room? maybe you know. Sorry, ladies. Here is a toilet for men. And it changes to the dissection room for large animals and birds. Very easy to care for washing, cleaning, and something like that. Yeah, it's a very good room. So this is the teacher's room. Also changes to the good viewing cafe space. I don't know why this good viewing, very comfortable room was occupied by teachers previously. I don't know. Anyway. OK, next, I talk about theme of our museum briefly. We say that our museum is the first environmental history museum in the world. The environmental history means time series relationships between human beings and natural environment. Learning and considering the relationships from ancient to present days, we can get the light to our future. A new way of life in Shizuoka. This is the theme of our activities. In modernness, rich nature spread in front of us. On the other hand, we get our rich life by consumption of the rich nature. As you know, it is not easy to keep both richness. However, in our museum, we can design true wealth or richness in our future through the museum exhibitions. So let's go to new style for expression, thought-provoking exhibitions. We have 10 rooms for exhibitions. This is room number 1, expressing an encounter with the global environmental history. In the first place, what is the environmental history? Visitors can understand from a short movie. Oh, sorry. Sure. Oh. Yosho. Okay. Short movie. Yeah. With refined design. Next, room number 2. It expresses nature in Shizuoka as friends and foe. Black space shows natural disasters, whereas white space shows wealth of nature. The design tells us these apparently extreme aspects of the nature are merely two sides of the same coin. And room number 3 expresses marine ecosystem in Shizuoka. We can see a series of exhibition cases produced with the school tables at the center of the room. The design, based on the blue color, allows visitors to instantly feel that here is a classroom under the water. Room number 4 expresses terrestrial ecosystem, such as the food web. The visitors can enjoy the exhibition with the old wood chairs used in the high school era. The room number 5 expresses environmental history in Shizuoka. Seesaw-like exhibition items express the relationship between nature and human activities. Nature and human activities from ancient to present days. Actually, the old Jomon was with a good balance between human and nature. And in Yayoi, Edo, and present, human becomes heavy against the nature gradually. Loop number six expresses the geological aspects and its history of Shizuoka. You can see many school chairs in the exhibition. Room number seven expresses biodiversity in Shizuoka. Approximately 3,000 specimens of plants, animals, and other organisms living in the prefecture are exhibited using a part of old school tables. Room number eight exhibits 20 skeleton specimens of vertebrates for expressing evolution of living organisms, following the typical classroom layout. When the visitors stand in front of the chalkboard, they were watched by the skeleton students of various vertebrates living on the earth. Room number nine is a place where visitors participate in a conference that we call Family Meeting for Future Earth. The visitors discussed with scientists about global environmental risks, such as global warming, population increasing, lack of various resources, and so on. And the visitors made realizing what happens in the real world. Final step is in the room number 10, making your image of new way of life towards our better future. In this room, visitors learn and think about the true wealth of life in the future without excessive environmental risks. And some kinds of cards are prepared for writing your proposal toward new way of life by the visitor's own. We create our future by ourselves, one by one. Here, I show you a short movie for demonstrating our concept and philosophy by storytelling method. Please enjoy to watch. Personified the earth. Shows the history of the earth. And growth of the girl means passing the time of the earth. Earth had experienced tectonics and the evolution of creatures. What is true wealth in our future? So back to the PowerPoint slide. Third topic is on our outreach activities applying similar design and concept. We have four sets of mobile exhibitions on fossils, insects, fishes, and plants that we call the museum caravan. There are examples of exhibition using the museum caravan found in a classroom in the school of the remote area. This unit is on the fossils. This is the museum caravan on the insect. Sometimes we museum researchers go to the school for giving lectures to school children using the museum caravan. This is one of fact data. The blue bar shows number of visitors and the red line shows number of places set the museum caravans in schools and the other places. And we have a plan to set it at total of 56 sites in this year. And in this year, we estimate that the number of visitors will excess about 800,000. As a long trend, you can see both numbers of visitors and places are increasing gradually. The last topic is on the contribution to the local communities. Examples showed here the pictorial book cafe, where the visitors can enjoy to read various kinds of pictorial books on nature, taking a good coffee or the other drink and food, and kids room for small children and parents. There are free space for everyone. We hope that our museum is not only a place for studying something, but also for spending time for recreation and relaxation. Yeah. Please remind your high school era. At that time, the school ought to have never been the boring place, only for studying for many persons. And We wish these rooms bring an opportunity to get to know and enjoy the museum from younger stages. We also believe that these rooms make a close communication between parents and children, feeling close to the nature. We are proud that these concept and design of our museum were evaluated worldwide, and we won several domestic and international awards. This is the first example of domestic one, and these are the following ones. That's all. Thank you for attention. And if you have an opportunity to travel to Japan, next year is the Olympic year, so please visit Japan, Shizuoka also, and our museum in the forest. Yeah. So, lastly, I'd like to introduce the other person, Dr. Ko of the Tokyo University, who is a supervisor of our museum on the exhibition design. So, Dr. Ko, could you please give us a few additional messages?
Thank you, Shibukawa-san. I am Tsuneo Ko, working as a project professor at the University Museum of the University of Tokyo. Museum of Natural and Environmental History Shizuoka was a quite unique project to transform from an abandoned high school to a museum. Through the project, many challenges popped up one after another, and I myself enjoy so much for overcoming them. I am grateful for having such an opportunity to sharing about this project. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.